I restarted your core systems. You weren't making any sense. And to be quite honest, I'm fucking terrified right now. And anyway, without you, I'm not going anywhere, so... Welcome back. Okay, first off... Let's try this again. Sam, voice authenticate. Dr. Emma Fisher, 140412. Okay. Okay. So, Sam, here's the deal. I'm stuck in the EAS arm for now. I think it's related to power, but a lot of the hatches are fully locked down, so I'm gonna try something different here. Okay. That's audio, at least. Almost there. Just a sec. There we go. Okay, Sam. I have rigged a connection sphere for you to use. You should be able to take control of this and fly around the station. It'll let you reach parts of the station your cameras can't see, and it'll let you wirelessly connect to non-station devices, like laptops. There. Looking good, Sam. Okay. Let's see if you can move it. Fly over to me. Great. Now turn around 180 degrees to face me. And fly back. Good. Good. There are more controls for translation and rotation, but I'll let you figure them out. You should still be able to identify objects and relay information to me like any other camera. Try it now.
Please repeat your previous request.
Come on, Sam. Respond on that sphere on the table.
Connection sphere is offline.
Okay, great. That works. Now, you can release yourself from the sphere and return to your main OS just like before. Try it now.
Sphere tracking is online, so its location will be displayed on your station map. To reconnect to your sphere, you can either quick connect directly from your map, or you can use a nearby module camera to access it. Reconnect to your sphere now.
Right, let's test out your sphere connection systems.
Connect to the laptop above the workbench. Once you're connected, attempt to download whatever data is left.
great. Can't believe that all actually worked.
Right. So, the rest of the station is dark, and the horizon arm is running on emergency power. The solar panels give us next to nothing this far from the sun. However, we do have an experimental fusion reactor on board, the EFR. If that can generate enough power, we can maybe get the universal hatches open. See what you can do. I'll try to find a way to contact the rest of the crew.
Sam, was that you? I think the backup batteries are struggling to cope. Hang on a sec. Oh, okay. I've switched off a few of the systems. Seems to have helped. I don't know how much longer this will last. We need the EFR online.
Message for home, please, Sam. Hey, guys, it's like 4 a.m. with you, but we just went by Florida and I saw Jacksonville all lit up. It never gets old, and, well, I just wanted to say hey. Things are great up here, and work is going smoothly, although Houston keeps changing their minds on what they want me to focus on. I'm hoping I'll get more info soon, though. Still, it's all good. Message in, Sam.
Okay, you should now be able to refer to that schematic to unlock the hatch via your system links. Thank you.
Please repeat your previous instruction.
Get to the EFR in EAS-1. If it's locked, you'll need a schematic to gain access. How that thing works. It was something Josh was working on. You're pretty much on your own, I'm afraid. Do what you can, just get it online. Good job. Thanks, Sam. The power's coming back on now. I'm running low on oxygen, so let's get a move on. How you were doing this. If you are doing this, but I need you to help me, Sam. I need to know what is going on. I need the crew. The power is back, but the hatch to Universal is still offline. I need you to find out what the problem is. Sam, give me a systems diagnostic.
System links in module EAS-1 are connected.
Must be something else then.
System links in module EAS-3 are connected.
Nothing out of the ordinary there.
System links in module UN-1 are connected.
Good. What else?
Module UN-1 hull contact points to EAS-3 are unresponsive.
This sounds bad. Okay, so the power is fine, but the hull connection points are misaligned. That we can fix. I can't get them open from here, but you should be able to reclamp the contact points from outside. Looks like you're going on your first spacewalk, Sam. Before you go outside, though, we need to update your sphere firmware to allow for exterior use. To upgrade, you'll have to scan the barcodes in EAS 11. Once you're fully updated, we'll get you outside. I'm granting you EVA permission now. The internal airlock hatch is now open. Great, that's you all set up. Okay, get those module clamps fixed, Sam.
Message to crew. Station doctor here. I've run weeklies on Josh, Jim, and May, but still need Staz and Ailsa for bloods and gym time. If anyone's got some actual bioscience for me to do, then throw it down my way. Directives from Houston have run dry. Sometimes I wonder why they sent me.
The control panel where you can rearrange the clamps is on the outer hull of EAS-3.
We could maybe check out a US-12 while we're out here.
Sam, it's still there. We can check it out.
Trying to unlock the door after the lockdown and the module started shaking, and then Sam jettisoned the module. How did Sam jettison the fucking module, Em? He shouldn't be able to do that. I'm going to try and work my way around the station exterior. Ah, shit.
Thank you.
What would you like me to do?
Sam, get those clamps disengaged. I'll be watching your feed. Straight down, Sam. The controls are at the bottom of the EAS arm. Getting closer. Look for the controls on EAS3. Thank you.
Thank you.
What would you like me to do, Emma?
Sam, get those clamps disengaged. I'll be watching your feed.
Thank you.
Connection points are reading true. I think that's working. Yeah, it's working. It's gonna take a few minutes while the module connection runs its pressure checks. Sam, while you're out there, take a closer look at the damage you detected earlier on the station exterior. What can you see?
Thank you.
The solar arrays are showing evidence of torsion and stress.
Whatever this station has gone through, the arrays had no chance. Take a closer look at the China and Russian arms. The damage to the top of them looked pretty severe.
Unknown material is present at hull fracture points.
That looks like what I found in EAS 4. What the hell is it? Bring the sphere back inside and meet me in EAS 3. Let's get this hatch open. I hope to God the others are okay.
Lights are on. Looks like the connection to Universal is holding. Great work, Sam. Now, lift the lockdown on the hatch, please. Okay, that's it open. Here we go. Here, let me. Hello? Elsa?
May? Stas? Jim. Sorry, mate. Fuck, I'm so sorry.